In peace, as in war, the ships of the Indian Navy have rendered a yeoman's service, patrolling the country's vast coastline, safeguarding its maritime interests. It was in 1961 when the aircraft carrier HMS Hercules was acquired as part of the country's defense modernization program and commissioned in the Indian Navy, rechristened as I.N.S. Vikrant. For the next few years, it was routine parades and drills, test flights and sorties to maintain battle readiness. And in 1965, when Pakistan troops infiltrated Indian territory in the Rann of Kutch, Vikrant's mettle was really put to test. I.N.S. Vikrant stood steadfast, keeping the Pakistan Navy at bay, while the Indian Air Force helped our Jawans flush out the Pakistani infiltrators out of Indian territory. In 1971, when Pakistan launched unprovoked air attacks on Indian air bases, Vikrant swung into action, wreaking havoc on Pakistani vessels at the Chittagong and Cox's Bazar ports. The Vikrant thus played a crucial and decisive role in determining the fate of the war, once again emphasizing its supremacy in the Bay of Bengal and the Indian Ocean. After a glorious era of dominance over the Indian seas, the Vikrant was decommissioned on 31st January 1997. The Vikrant is now permanently docked in Mumbai, and it welcomes all in its new avatar. Welcome aboard to the Indian Museum ship I.N.S. Vikrant. These are the officers who have successfully transformed the Vikrant into what it is today. Take a trip across time with me to moments in history you missed, probably because you weren't even born. I'll tell you tales of Vikrant's valiant men and their heroic exploits. The first is a tragic tale of the I.N.S. Kukri.
The fateful night of the 9th of December, at the culmination of a duel between our frigate and an enemy submarine, the frigate's Kukri was hit and sunk. Out of a complement of 263 officers and sailors, only 67 survived. Many brave sailors lost their lives with the ship. Seated on the bridge of the ship went down its commander, Captain Mahendranath Malla.
I was on the bridge when the ship was hit. Electricity and communication failed. In the meantime, second hit came and captain ordered, abandon the ship.
I saw one of the sailors offering a life jacket to the captain, but he refused to accept it. In turn, he said, you don't worry about me, you save your life.
For gallantry and service above and beyond the call of duty, Commander Mahendranath Malla was awarded the Mahavir Chakra posthumously. And before you knew it, another Pakistan submarine, the PNS Ghazi, was moving around in Indian waters with even greater ambitions to sink the mighty Vikrant. The Indian Navy, of course, swung into action, and with a few strategically placed depth charges, relegated the Ghazi to its permanent resting place at the bottom of the ocean. The Kukri was avenged. The Vikrant is a repository of memorabilia and marvels of engineering. This deck is actually a giant elevator that can lift an entire aircraft, taking it up from the lower decks all the way up to the flight deck and bringing it down once again after the sorties. There are two such elevators, one up in the front and another at the back. This bomb lift used to take the heaviest of bombs right up to the flight deck to be fitted onto the aircraft. Come, let's take a look at some of the smaller yet significant accessories. The Vikrant armory consisted of a wide range of arms and ammunition. Rockets are the primary assault weapons for an aircraft. Rockets can combine pinpoint accuracy with massive destructive capability. Come down from up in the skies to nearer sea level and get ready to go below. This is no alien spacesuit. Believe it or not, it's actually a diving suit of times gone by. The mask alone weighs 24 kilos. And it takes an entire support team to put a diver underwater. Keeping pace with technology and leaping ahead, divers today move around in specialized lightweight suits like these. They can now stay down underwater for hours, conveniently inspecting hulls and even conducting repairs on the high seas. This is an underwater chariot. It allows a diver to move fast, undetected, right up to the enemy ships, to plant bombs and zip right back. In critical operations, chariots like these also serve as suicide stealth bombers. Submarines are a very critical component of a country's defense setup, because they can move about freely, virtually unseen and unheard underwater, when every minute is fraught with danger. Meanwhile, these escape suits can help the trap crew get away to safety, as shown in the simulated exercise. Playpens in peace. The life rafts are a very critical complement to a sailor's life on board. They can be true lifesavers when all around has been rent asunder and it's man overboard. Once safe on the life raft, how does a sailor in distress catch the eye of the distant rescuer? Simple. Just pull out a flare or a smoke gun. How about a mirror? The parachute is another critical device. It can carry an ejected pilot to safety, to live and fight another day. It can also drop men and supplies behind enemy lines to keep a campaign going. Pre-flight briefing is as important as the mission itself, because all details are discussed here at minutest levels. The timings of the operations are synchronized to the second. Any and every flight operation on board a carrier involves a coordinated effort of its ground crew. The complex data of each and every aircraft has to be logged to facilitate maintenance and support in a systematic and methodic manner on an aircraft-to-aircraft basis, depending, of course, on the nature of individual needs. The aircraft detecting radar, ADR, scours the skies for approaching enemy aircraft. The very sight of one raises an alarm and has the pilot scrambling to take to the skies. Simultaneously, the ship's anti-aircraft guns also swing into action and spew forth their firepower onto the incoming enemy. Once back from the mission, the aircraft was taken to the hangars below for scrutiny, routine inspection and checks. Here, every nut and bolt was confirmed to get the aircraft shipshape, ready for the next sortie. All repair and maintenance was conducted in-house at this onboard workshop. The Vikrant is a mighty ship. It's much larger than a football field. 708 feet long, 128 feet wide. It has 13 decks in all, 7 above and 6 below the waterline. Have you any idea how this 21,000 ton ship was propelled forward? What you are about to see now was once the privilege of a select few. This complex assembly of turbines, reduction gears and shafts chugged away relentlessly once upon a time to provide the power to the glory of Vikrant. Equally invisible were the men's quarters and the rest and recreation areas. Seeing the men relax here, you won't have believed that these were the men who filled the uniforms and won the medals that we saw earlier. War or no war, the ship's galley was always an area of action to keep the men's bellies filled and spirits high. The Vikrant was also well equipped and prepared for all medical emergencies. From a full-fledged operation theatre to an onboard clinic and a sick bay. Let's now take a break and move to the square rig cafeteria. It has been created exclusively as a relief center for you to relax in and perhaps ponder over the sheer experience of sharing space with history. Standing majestically tall on this vast sprawling flight deck are the fighter aircraft that added to and extended the reach of Vikrant's extraordinary sting. The Sea King helicopter, a versatile multitasking long-haul machine, equipped with both sensors and weapons, capable of performing solo search and rescue missions and attacking enemy sites with equal ease and alacrity. And there is the Seahawk. Unlike a normal aircraft, the Seahawk needs no runway to land. It can land straight down like a helicopter. The pride of Vikrant's Cobra Squadron was the awesome Elise. This fighter aircraft inflicted untold damage on the enemy every time it went into action, as was amply witnessed in the War of 1971. The last aircraft may have taken off a long time ago, but the Vikrant is still the takeoff point for flights of fancy across time into yesterday and even tomorrow.